mid.
Thanks. I got one more magic trick for you. Before I do... Grandpa made macaroni and cheese 7 days a week. Sundays were cool, though. Sundays we'd go to church, and after church we'd have to play in the big backyard, swing in the cherry tree, until Grandpa called us in for a steaming bowl of macaroni and cheese. And then we'd sit down and watch The Wonderful World of Disney. Then he'd tuck us into bed, and he would do this magic trick. It's a funny thing, I never realized until my grandpa passed away what a sneaky guy he was. He was always full of sayings, jokes, little rhymes and poems, and I learned them all off by heart because they were so funny. And it wasn't until he was gone I realized he tricked me into learning his values, his morals, his beliefs, all hidden in these little messages. They were funny. He used to say things like, "Shawn, he who laughs last thinks slowest." Talking about you. Of all the sayings my grandpa had, my absolute favorite was, "Yesterday is history. Tomorrow's a mystery, but today is a gift. That's why they call it the present." Grandpa called this the thread of life. He said life was a lot like a piece of thread. There was a beginning and an end, but they weren't really that important. What was important was the stuff in the middle. He said life was fragile, and so was the thread. And yet both are strong enough to bind things together. He said in life there'd be good times and bad times, successes and failures, friends and enemies, and love's won and love's lost. And through it all, it was important to have the good and the bad, because without one, how would you ever know you had the other? I remember when Grandma passed away, we used to go visit Grandma. Grandma said there were two sets of numbers on Grandma's stone. The first set was when she came, and the second set was when she left, but that they weren't important. What was important was the little dash between the numbers. The smallest part was the most important part. He used to have a saying for that too. He used to say, "It doesn't matter the things you have, the clothes, the cars, the cash. What matters most is how you live in love and how you spend your dash." I hope that your dash has been well spent, like mine, here on board this ship. And that the memories of the Norwegian Star will last you a lifetime. And that maybe, just maybe, my family and our magic might be just a small part of that dash. And God willing, somewhere, someday, we'll all meet again. On the thread of life. Thanks for watching, folks.